Access your free language gifts right now, before they expire. Here's what you're getting this month. First, the Asking for Directions conversation cheat sheet. Can you give directions in your target language? If not, then this beginner conversation cheat sheet is for you. You'll learn all the questions and phrases for asking and giving directions. So download it for free right now. Second, the Listening Comprehension course for beginners. How are your listening skills? Take this beginner video course to sharpen them up. Third, can you talk about drinks in your target language? Learn how to say coffee, beer, tea, wine, and much more with this quick vocab bonus. Fourth, how do you say autumn in your target language? Don't know? Access this 1-minute lesson to learn all the autumn-related words and phrases. If you want to learn these words fast, use the free audio slideshow tool inside the lesson. Fifth, the 45 must-know gym words. Words like cardio, bench press, abs, deadlifts, and leg day. Don't skip this lesson. You'll master all the must-know gym words with this next vocabulary lesson. Sixth, free audiobooks. Unlock our huge library of language learning audiobooks. Save them to any device and listen and learn. They're yours to keep forever. And finally, the deal of the month. If you want to finally master the language with lessons by real teachers and our complete language learning program, get 40% off Premium or Premium Plus with the Epic Sale. To get your gifts and language learning resources, click the link in the lesson description below. Download them right now before they expire. Hey everyone, welcome to the Monthly Review, the monthly show on language learning, where you discover new learning strategies, motivational tips, study tools, and resources. By the way, all the lessons and bonuses you're about to see can be downloaded for free on our website. So click the link in the description right now to sign up for your free lifetime account. Okay, today's topic is the secret to speaking more of your target language. If you're like most language learners, then above all, you want to speak and understand more of your target language, right? Well, keep watching. You'll learn how to prepare ahead of time to speak more, how to put this tactic to use with our learning program, and how to get free cheat sheets that'll get you speaking more. The secret to speaking more of your target language. If you're like most language learners, then above all, you want to speak and understand more of your target language. But how do you speak more when you're just starting out, when you can't yet create sentences off the top of your head? Here are some tips. Let's jump into part one, how to prepare ahead of time to speak more. So, what's the secret to speaking more of your target language? It's something called preparation. And believe it or not, you've likely used it if you've ever had to give a speech or a presentation. So, what do we mean by preparation? Imagine that you have to go open a bank account in the language that you're learning. How would you do it? You can go in there, grunt, and use body language, or you can first come up with a list of words and phrases you need to know before you go. Like debit card, bank account, I want to open a bank account, and minimum balance. You may want to look up the grammar rules for how to say, I want to. Once you know these words and phrases, you translate them into your target language and you go over to the bank to open an account. Or let's say you're meeting a person for the first time. What are some things you'd say to them? Things like, what's your name? My name is, where are you from? I am from, and so on. So you prepare a list of words and phrases, all the things you'd want to say in that situation. You translate them ahead of time so that you can communicate effectively. That's preparation. And preparation works because most conversations are predictable to a degree. For example, most conversations with friends start with greetings and catching up on how you've been. And if you know the lines for greetings, catching up, and talking about your weekend, then you can easily handle such a conversation. The point is, the more you prepare, the more you learn to speak without needing a teacher. So, how do you prepare? Part 2, how to speak more through preparation. Here are some tips. If you're using our learning program, 1, take our audio and video lessons. You'll find these in our lesson library and just focus on the conversational lessons. Lessons are just 3 to 15 minutes in length, and in the first minute, you'll hear a practical conversation. For example, meeting someone new, catching up with a friend, or ordering at a restaurant. Then our teachers break down and explain every word and grammar rule, so you can learn these lines and conversations ahead of time. Number two, download the audio dialogue track. This gives you just the conversation. So when you finish a lesson, download it for easy review. Then make a playlist out of all of them and play the conversations on repeat. This will make them much easier to remember. Number three, save the lesson notes. The lesson notes give you the lesson in writing, so you can read the lesson dialogue, the grammar explanations, and cultural insights for every lesson. Download and keep the notes for conversations you think are useful. For example, if you want to talk about the weather and you took a lesson on that, then download the lesson notes for that lesson. Now, if you're looking to prepare ahead of time for specific topics, then do this next one. Number four, use our free PDF conversation cheat sheets. These conversation cheat sheets teach you words and phrases for all kinds of common conversation topics, like weather, hobbies, family, plans, and much more. You can prepare for the most common conversations with these cheat sheets. If you want to access our free conversation cheat sheets, leave a comment down below and we'll give you the link. Number five, look up lesson topics in our lesson library. If you want to open a bank account or eat at a certain restaurant and you don't know how to talk about these topics, find a lesson about it in our lesson library. Number six, if you're a Premium Plus user, simply ask your teacher to point you to lessons for certain topics, or even better, ask them for potential lines, and you can even practice speaking. Just record yourself, send it in, and your teacher will provide you feedback on what to say and how. Number seven, do it the old school way. Sit down, think of a topic you want to talk about. Make a list of all the words you think you need, all the phrases you want to say or may hear in that conversation. Then, translate those words and phrases into your target language. So, let's recap. Most conversations are predictable. You can prepare ahead of time by thinking of all the words and lines you'll need for various conversations. And you can prepare with 1. Our audio and video lessons, 2. Conversation tracks, 3. Lesson notes, 4. Free PDF cheat sheets, 5. By looking up specific topics in the lesson library, 6. Asking your Premium Plus teacher, and 7. By manually coming up with a list of the words and phrases and translating them. Starting easy with language learning is sometimes the best way to get into a new language. But before you feel guilty about wanting to learn the easy way, don't worry. It's fine to start the easy way. You wouldn't expect to lift 200 pounds on your first day at the gym, right? And language is no different. Start easy so you can build up to tackling greater challenges later. In this video, we'll explore 7 easy ways to learn a language. The reason it's okay to start easy is the same as the reason you should start easy in the gym. You just can't expect to lift 200 pounds on day one. You start with 5 pounds, then you move up to 10, 15, 20. And language is the same way. Learn a few phrases today, a basic conversation tomorrow. In a few weeks, you'll be able to speak for up to 3 minutes in your target language. Then you'll reach 5, then 10, then 20 minutes. Success comes step by step, little by little. So it's important to make things that are easy to do and easy to continue part of your routine. If you try to study for 2 hours a day with nothing but a big textbook, you may overwhelm yourself, get discouraged, and get tired. You might not stick with it because it's too hard to do. Things that are easy to do are easy to continue. So here are some resources to help you learn language the easy way. Number one, take audio and video lessons. Listening to audio and watching video lessons is an easy way to consume language. Most of our lessons are 5 minutes on average, so you don't have to spend too much time at the computer. You can even learn on our app while you're commuting, working around the house, or out on a walk. Number two, take lessons with Alexa. If you own an Amazon Echo, Dot, or Show, or are planning to get one, you'll want to make sure to download some apps to help you learn your target language. Take a look through the Amazon Skill Store. You can listen to lessons and other audio materials actively or passively, whenever the time is right for you. Number three, download the lesson dialogues and immerse yourself. With every audio lesson, you get a dialogue track, just the lesson conversation. These are just 5 to 20 seconds long. When you finish a lesson, download the track. Make a playlist of all of them. Then play them and immerse yourself in the language. Number four, the word of the day. This will take you a minute or less. Sign up for our free word of the day email lessons. It'll be a small boost to your vocabulary every day. Number 5, vocab slideshows. You can access vocabulary slideshows on any audio lesson or vocab list. Just press play and watch the slideshow. That's it. This is a fast and easy way to review words from a lesson. You can even put the slideshow on loop to review as much as you want. Number 6, the Daily Dose of Language app. This app is for the iPhone, iPad, and Android. With this bonus app, you'll get daily mini lessons covering phrases, grammar, culture, holidays, slang, and more. Every day is something new. Plus, these lessons will take you just a minute or two to complete. Number 7, print out our lessons as physical study material. You might be wondering why you should bother to print anything if all the lesson content is already online. But if you have the material sitting right in front of you, it's a lot easier to just glance through and start learning. With our Word Bank study tool, you can create your own word and phrase lists and print them out. Reviewing takes just a few minutes. You can also print out the lesson notes that come with every audio and video lesson. You'll also find our extensive reading books, which will help you to read faster. You'll find these in the lesson library. Are you afraid of making mistakes in your target language? Afraid you'll never ever be able to have a conversation or give a presentation? Or maybe you're afraid of something else? In this video, we'll cover 4 fears related to language learning and how to overcome them. The first one is, I'm afraid I'm not good enough to speak. I freeze. Do you feel like you're not good enough to speak yet? A lot of people can relate to this one. Probably all language learners have felt this at some point. It's a pretty common fear. Here are some tips to overcome it. First, speak from day one. The best way to get good at speaking is to practice speaking. If you're holding yourself back because you think you're not good enough, you're making a mistake. That's exactly why you're not improving. You need to open your mouth and start talking. Second, if you're not sure what to say to start speaking, consider practicing with existing dialogues. In our lessons, you get scripts for introducing yourself, making small talk, ordering food, expressing opinions, and much more. If you're looking for some things to use for speaking practice, the lessons will give you the exact lines and conversations. Our third tip, learn with your own teacher with our Premium Plus plan. With Premium Plus, you get an actual native speaker teacher to tell you what to say and how to say it. You can actually learn to speak with the help of a real native teacher. Fear number 2 is, I'm afraid I'll never be fluent. This is a common fear for beginner learners. Once you start improving and seeing progress, this goes away. When you're just starting out with a new language, fluency can feel like an impossible goal. There are so many new things to learn and so many methods you can use. It's easy to get overwhelmed with all the options. But you can't let yourself fall into that trap. The longer you keep at it, the better your language skills will become. And slowly, you'll stop worrying about fluency. What's important is that you put in time and continue working on moving forward. So, how do you overcome worries about never becoming fluent? How do you motivate yourself to continue? First, set small, specific goals instead of just saying, I want to become fluent. How do you know when you've become fluent? Fluency is hard to determine. Instead of creating a vague, hard-to-understand goal for yourself, focus on working towards smaller goals. For example, set goals like being able to introduce yourself or having a 5-minute conversation, something you can measure so you'll know when you've reached it. Fluency can be difficult to measure. If you set goals that you can measure, you can track your progress. This helps keep your motivation up over time. The third fear is, I'm afraid I'm not actually learning or making progress. If you're afraid you're not making progress, there are a few things you can do right now. First of all, review. A lot of people hear a new phrase once and think they'll remember it, but that usually doesn't happen. So when they forget what they've learned, they get worried that they're not learning or that the lessons don't work. But the truth is, you have to review again and again to truly master something. Second, use the dashboard to track your progress. If numbers and data are helpful for you as you track your learning, check out our dashboard. It tracks your progress and gives you dynamic reports. Third, try a harder lesson on the site. You might not understand it all at first, and that's okay. You'll be able to, after some study. All lessons come with line-by-line translations, and our teachers explain every single word. Break down these harder lessons. If you have to work a little more slowly, it's okay. When you finish the lesson, you can be sure of your progress because you'll be able to understand something you didn't understand a few minutes earlier. Fourth, learn one-on-one with a teacher with our Premium Plus plan. They will personally review your writing and your speaking and will fix your mistakes. Getting regular feedback from a native speaker is a great way to know if you're making progress. It's such a great feeling to hear a native speaker tell you, "Wow, you're getting good." The fourth fear is, "I'm afraid of not understanding anything I hear." This is very common. You hear advanced grammar and vocabulary and it goes completely over your head. You have no idea what you've just heard. Here are some tips for working on this issue. If you're taking an advanced lesson, read along with the script. Reading along with our line-by-line dialogue is the best way to improve your understanding of advanced conversations. If you're in a real-life situation, the solution is quite simple. Learn useful phrases like, "Excuse me, can you say it again slower?" Or, "Can you say it in simpler words?" Or even just, "I don't understand." There's nothing wrong with saying that you didn't understand something or asking for help. These are some common fears for most language learners, and we hope these tips help you. Is there anything else that you're afraid of when it comes to learning another language? Let us know in the comments, and maybe we can share some suggestions for how to overcome them. Great work! Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.